and welcome to another tutorial with me. The last one has been a while, so this is going to be a big one. One that has been requested a couple of times. We are going to turn this lovely and hatchway here into a Cardassian. So this is a picture I didn't do before, and every actor Cardassian build, or any species actually, is different from each other, so I have no idea how long this is going to be. I hope it won't be too long, but since this is a new picture, we never know. So I've chosen this picture because it shows the forehead nicely and part of the neck, as well as having the hair out of the way, and it's lovely dark, and this outfit could easily go for an alien outfit. I don't know. So I chose this one. It also is nice that it's a half profile looking at us. So I'm going to show you what we're going to work with. I opened a couple of pictures of Cardassians to borrow face parts from it. And that means we are going to do a little puzzle. So one of the parts is this one here. So I don't think we're going to use this maybe for part of the ear or part of the neck here, it depends. And we have a key right here. It is pretty small. Sometimes I'm going to borrow parts like the forehead or part of the eye part. Same goes for this one, and this one. So we'll have to see which works best with this. Sometimes you're lucky, you can just transplant a full face, like for example this one, and delete the eyes here and the mouth and make it fit with the face that you're working with. Most of the times that doesn't work though. So let's see how we're going to do this. If you hear strange noises in the recording, we have a construction site outside, so I'm really, really sorry. That's annoying. So I hope it isn't too bad. Okay, let's first check out the face here. And this is half profile, and this would work. This could work as well. This, I don't think so. Maybe this one. Okay, let me first. This is a bit sharper. So let me actually take part of this one here. I'm using Control C for copying and bring it over here. Then of course flip it because it's the wrong direction. Then to check how it works, I'm going to lower the opacity. Now you see that both faces are not on top of each other, but I think this one looks really nice. I'm using transform, control and T. Bring this little thing in this eye here so it rotates around this. It will make things a bit easier. Look at this, that looks actually really, really nice. This can work. What you see is that the ear is lining up nicely here. The chin is lining up as well. Mouth can work as well. There, so yeah, I think this will work. So we take this and then we press it here. Oh, this is nice, right? Let's take it like that and it's still working now. No, I'm not making it that easy. So, as always, we work with non-destructive measures here. So we click on the Cardassian layer and add a layer mask down here. Make sure that the white gray is enabled. Take a black brush and start to delete parts of the Cardassian. Which parts we actually need, so we'll take another test. since we use the layer mask, we can enable and disable stuff all the time, so it doesn't really matter how much we take out right now, because we can blend it in again. So here is Anne's hair. Might be part of the neck back later. And now I'm going to delete all the stuff that we don't need. And here you can have a nice preview of how it will look later, so that will be very, very nice. I'm using a soft brush here for blending already, though we don't need that. Because I'm using the soft brush, so I take the hard brush and make sure to delete all this stuff. And I'm going to do one thing that we tried before. I'm bringing down the spacing here so we have a really nice and clean, smooth line. Go around. It's a bit slow right now because of the recording, but we can work on that. Because we have all the time in it. So, with this, next I'm going to do is I'm going to mask out. So we can have Anne's eyes here. I'm changing to white to actually bring parts back now. One thing you notice, of course, is that the color of doesn't work at all. There is something we need to add here because the face doesn't work. But you can see it's going to be really nice once we're done. This is actually what I meant with transplanting the face onto another. With this picture it worked perfectly. With others it doesn't, so I bring this spoon right here. This spoon is important, so we want to have the full thing out. So we can either try to adjust the skin from N to the Cardassian skin or the other way around, or we can anything. It depends on what kind of character you want to have, basically. Cardassians are usually kind of grayish with a bit of greenish in it. But I also have done a Cardassian before that was black. I have Asian descended Cardassians because in this huge planet, I don't think that all Cardassians have the same skin tone just because of climate changes and stuff like that. So you can just go nuts. Whatever you want to have. Even in the show, we have seen people with the darker skin and lighter skin, like I've shown you earlier, this Martina here, she's rather light, while Kira is lighter but darker than her. She's a bit more grayish, she's a bit more greenish. So it really depends on what you want to do. So, This topic makes me thirsty. What we also want to do is keep end mouth. Because she has a lovely mouth. And why not have a Cardassian that smiles at me? So. This is what we have so far. Lots of work still left, but it's a start. Okay. What I'm going to do is I'm trying to adjust the Cardassian skin layer to Anne's face. We have done this all fitting before. And I'm still going to show you, because I can't expect you to watch all the other videos now. So first I'm going to try select a color and make it a clipping mask to the Cardassian facial stuff layer with holding down the Alt key and clicking between them on the line or right click and clipping mask. That means whatever I do now only affects the Cardassian face parts. So we see green stuff in here. Let's see if we can make it a bit more. And it's not green. Maybe it's yellow. But that works. I'm just actually playing around. I don't know exactly what I'm doing, which is probably a surprise. I can't even. I know that we are here in the reds, and now we're playing around with blue and yellow and magenta colors here, and brightness with the black slider here. I am really bad with explaining this stuff. I'm actually just trying whatever we have here to see if we can make it fit a bit better with the skin that we have. This should help. Look at that, that's so much better already. It's not perfect yet, but it's better. No. This is selective color, then we are going to shift some new saturation, make it a clipping mask as well, because we only want to change this edge. Adjust the color a bit more like this. You see it's only plus one, but it's already different. Minimalistic. I'm going to add this contrast. Need to keep the mask. A bit lighter here. And here you can see already that it's better. Okay, now at first we are going to back to the Cardassian layer, sharp the edge, and now we want to construct a bit of the stuff here. First I'm going to disable these layers here. Use them again later, but I want to use the original layer stuff that we have to reconstruct this part. So first I'm going to enable part of the face again. So we can take from here and use for long stay. Counseling is a tool I really, really like because you can just take stuff from the image and cloud it next to it or on the other side of the image or wherever you need it. So I still want to do non-destructive part, so I'm taking a new layer all over the face. I don't use a clipping mask yet, so because that would mean it follows the transparency of this year and we wouldn't see any new parts actually. I can show you. Take this and that, but you don't see anything new. As soon as I unclip this, there we go. That is why I don't use clipping mask right now. You just clone stamp in parts of cheek here, parts of this. It's not very. So. The opacity, so I can erase the parts or mask out the parts I don't need. Take a brush, the hard one, bring down the spacing, draw a few lines on it. As you see, I'm masking a line. After 9, I just hold on shift and click a spot, and then it makes a line from the first to the next spot. Now you see the case constructed. I'm going to free that out. Around the eye, so we don't have too much of the old skin showing, which would be easier with the adjusting. So it goes all the way. Now, since here's the hair, they're doing this one trick I showed you last time with the blue, going down to like 25 or so. And merge your splicer. Sometimes it's a bit much filled, so I'm going to fill even more. Just to blend this. Okay, one thing is that the desk you have these things. Let me show you. At the neck here. So we are going to try to use that. Which of course is more difficult with the hood, but we just try to make it work. I don't know how to make it work yet, but we'll see if it works. So I'm going to still down, that's it. I'm still doing find the exoplanet quite a good contact. See how that works. So I'm going in for the shop. First, I'm just ask God. What's it like? As I said before, I'm totally winning this year. So let's see how it works. If it works, so. Having tea in here. So if you hear any buzzing sounds, that's why. I can just do this for a moment and I'm going to read this part of the loop. See if I can work something out of that. Copy paste. I need this update to see. This is one of the tools I really, really like. I can form and shape stuff with that, which can be really awesome, like you can see right now. I'm reshaping part of the HUD. Hood. I hope you're saying that. I don't know. Well, yeah, I understand. So let's I want to see part of this lovely Cardassian neck, so that's what I'm trying to do right now. I am trying to bring this together. Now we are going to clean up the Cardassian skin again. That looks a bit weird. Okay, let's see. No, wrong tumor. That I'm clicking here will be fixed. I think that doesn't work because the out of the neck, you know, it's too much to the front. So, the shoulder of N, so I can draw that, would go. From here to there. So, this part here needs to be a bit more there. In other words, that doesn't work. So let's see if we can do it differently. Alright, looks like we're moving part of this. I like using the puppet board tool as well, but right now I'm going to try to so code we control C for copy and control V for paste. Put this a bit more here. First I'm going to blend it out here, so go back to the other Cardassian layer on the mask, their color. Make a mask layer for this one as well. Okay, we'll have to take a hard brush because it will get here. And then we take a soft brush for easier blending of this. Changing a bit of perspective and to fix a part down here. This isn't perfect, but it looks better than before. Let me save this. Okay. Yes. Now what I'm going to do, we're not done yet with motion. I'm going to group this, mark them all and pull them into this little folder here. And then I'm clipping these layers here. That the skin adjustment back to them. So, this looks like a nice start. And now we're going to play with the details. First, the mouth. Go back in here. Mouth goes on this layer. So, we take a white brush, soft edges, and so this is where the original is. So I'm going to make sure it's there. And colors. And not very happy with this. The original, he just showed some hair, and we don't need that here. She has no hair. Oh, okay, I'm sorry. That was his dental. I have to go and need a brush. Trying to keep the original lashes in there. Okay. That seems to look nice now. I want to do the good part. I walked around because I need to move that up more. I want to do a new layer for a little bit of shadow because of this action. So I'm taking this dark color here because it's shadow in the hood, so I know it works. Take a soft brush at the size of your body. And make a new mask. And go around. To paint around the neck part. This actually doesn't look good. It doesn't look bad. Yes, it doesn't look good. Oh my god. So yeah, it doesn't look bad. And this, ladies and gentlemen, could be Cardassian in another way. What I'm going to do, because I don't like the way this looks, is I'm going to bring down the tone of the lips. I'm taking the skin color, but a little bit darker, so I'm going for something like here. And I'm going to soft brush on over these lips. Because this folder is the Cardassian stuff, so I need to go to the lower menu. So I'm going to go over here. See, right now it looks that was still on the wrong layer. So there we go. And you on the original layer, the other one that was not destructive. So now I'm going to change the blender mode, or blend mode of this layer. I'm going to check which looks nice. I know for some of these blend modes what they do. Most of them I have any knowing. Now this actually looks rather nice, let me see what it has. This looks nice as well. So this is the color mode. At least the original color is just drawn over the color while the details are preserved. And saturation is the same but with saturation. So I personally like the color one more. It goes with the whole color scheme. So, yes, ladies and gentlemen, it's our Cardassian. And anyway, we have a bit more. And the example, the store, these switches at the side view. So what I'm going to do now, just take my brush and take a look where this goes. So, let's take this. I'm going to use the hard brush again. Soften this a little bit too. And put a little skin around it. This is something I'm going to put in here. And also, it's too much better than it. All those little details that often get missed, and it's much nicer. What you also can do is many Cardassians with black hair. I've seen Cardassians with brown hair and such, so it's okay if you keep it like that, but you can darken the hair, of course, if you like. And you can, as we have seen, pictures here, there's like a bluish color in this. Yeah, I'm very, very sure it has a meaning, but I don't play Cardassians that often to know it. Maybe they're married or they're non-married, I have no idea, to be honest. But if you want to do that, you can do it, of course. Just go and up here, the new layer, click on masking with the folder. So I'm going to take this color in. I just use the brush and then hold Alt down for the color picker. You can also use the color picker in here. And then turn back to the brush. I'm going to use a soft brush inside here. And I keep the flow low because that makes it look more natural. As you see, it is not uniform, the same color everywhere. So here, so take this. Move around the edges a bit. And then, I would take it like this. Blend layer to see the blend mode. Just inside. depends on if you want to have it dark, of course you need to use a darker blue, like this for example. And use a different brand mode and stuff like that. But it's really that easy. So now we have it. We have planted a Cardassian face on Anne Hathaway's face. As you can see, none of the original is lost. Let me show you this. But there is the original. I hold down Alt and click on the little eye here to just show this one face. And as you can see, the original is still there. Everything else above is layers and layer masks and blend modes and stuff like that. And this is why I like the non-destructive way. If I see I mess up anywhere, I can fix it easily with going onto that layer and fixing stuff. And I don't have to redo everything again. So yeah, this is how I turn a lovely young lady into a Cardassian face. And I actually like this picture so much, I might actually try to play Cardassian one day and use her for that. So one thing that I of course would do now is to get rid of the background here and add another background for that, maybe a Cardassian embassy or Federation stuff, or maybe even a Starfleet ship or Planet View, anything that works with this. And yeah, so I hope this was helpful and that you are going to try to make your own Cardassians. In case it doesn't work like this with a face transplant, you can absolutely go in and take smooth parts of different pictures and try to puzzle them together onto the face, as long as you afterwards remember to adjust the skin colors. As you saw, it's really easy with selective color, hue saturation, brightness, contrast. There's also the channel mixer, curves and levels and stuff like that. Just try. Just play around with it. If you use the non-destructive way, nothing gets broken. Even if you don't use the non-destructive way, nothing gets broken. You can save it under a different file name and play around with things. You can go in and just copy this background layer onto the new one and work with the new background layer and keep the old one untouched. So just to be sure that you always have a backup for that. So that's it for today. If you have any more requests, please feel free to comment. Next time, I don't know what I'm going to do exactly. I might try to clean them. I might try to use a species that nobody ever heard of. I don't know. I know I have a request for choosing background images that is not lost on me. I have it on my list. I just I'm trying to collect the different background images that work to show bad and good choosings of backgrounds. So this will come to. If you have any other requests, please feel free to comment below and I'm going to look at it and see if I can do it. I mean, I didn't know if I can do Cardassians again, but I did. So I see you next time and thank you for watching. And stay creative, have fun, and bye bye.